George Tallis was an Irish immigrant who came to Australia in the 1870s and achieved great things in his new homeland. He was a theatrical entrepreneur, a businessman, a philanthropist. He established the Ballura property down on the Mornington Peninsula, and he was knighted for his services to Australia during wartime. The sale commences with this absolutely wonderful quartet of Impressionist paintings. You have Rupert Bunny's mother and child on the beach, listed at lot one in the sale. The piece de resistance, unquestionably, is Elioth Gruner's On the Sands, lot two. This is a painting which was exhibited at a special NGV exhibition in the 1920s, and it's actually been away from the public view for almost 100 years. It has unbroken ownership in the Tallis family through descent through all of the 20th century. I think it's particularly special that the current owner, who's Tallis's great-great-granddaughter, is actually setting up an award in statistics at the University of New South Wales with the proceeds from the sale of this collection. So it has a feel-good element about it, as well as the propensity for some real fireworks in the sale room. The Penley Boyd is a classic view of Portsea Front Beach and the pier from 1920. It's a previously undocumented and unexhibited painting, just glows with that shimmer of sunlight on the water. He's a very underrated painter in general, but an underrated member of the Boyd family dynasty. The Tom Roberts painting, it's an untitled Dandenong landscape circa 1923, and it's the fourth work in this really beautiful Tallis quartet. It is a painting which is documented. It appears in Helen Toplis's catalogue raisonné, significant because of its size, but also the subject. It depicts Roberts's former home at Callista in the Dandenongs.